No matter what happened, boy, keep that motherfucker rolling, boy.
Yeah, man. Yeah, that's what's up. That's what's up. That's an interesting thing you said that, man, because, you know, the youth need to hear that, man, you know. And it's crazy you said that because I was going to ask you, man, how do you feel, you know, about the whole snitch thing, you know, because you got people who are a snitch and then, you know, they'll pretty much everybody's excuse for them snitching is, you know, I had to do what I had to do. I got a family and I got this and that. And it kind of piggybacked to what you said, to do everything solo. So do you feel like the snitches, like people, I'm not going to say the snitches, let's say people who have, you know, gave information or whether they were informant or not, do you feel like they should get a pass or have excuses in most cases? Do you feel like some of them do have valid points? How's your whole view on the whole snitching thing, man? Because I know it's a lot different now from what it was back then.
That's an individual thing. That's an individual thing. But they say they outpolling them, say there's 14, 15 murders.
14.
14 murders.
He admitted to 14 murders.
Him and his homie from D.C., right?
Right, yep. 14.
So, that's electric. That's a chair type shit. That's the chair type shit. You know? They said that's what Alpo was facing. And they said, what's his name? The cat from D.C.?
Wayne Perry.
Yeah, Wayne Perry. But they call that jail up in Colorado where they from? Where they at?
In the Max.
Yeah, they call it the last place on earth. That's where niggas going. They call that shit the last place on earth. I like to talk and get information. You know what I'm saying? I ain't debating with you to, you know what I'm saying, to argue. I'm trying to build with you. You know what I'm saying? So I'd be like, who told you not to snitch? Who told you? Yeah, you're not supposed to be no tattletale ass nigga. You know what I'm saying? But who told you not to snitch? Just tell me that. Like, part of the street is cold, nigga. You ain't from the streets. What cold, nigga? So niggas can't even really answer you. You know what I mean? So say you part of a crew. This is the niggas you grew up with. Like, you know these niggas since grade school. Like, drinking motherfucking chopping milks with these niggas. You know what I'm saying? So, when y'all get older and y'all hustling together, what you gonna do when, you know, little Ray Ray, he, y'all get arrested, as nine of y'all, you know? You know Lil Ray Ray ain't about, you don't believe in Lil Ray Ray? You don't believe in Lil Ray Ray when y'all on the block, when y'all on the court? Then you don't pick Lil Ray Ray up. So now y'all get picked up by the police, nigga. All nine of y'all. You know Lil Ray Ray? You believe, you got faith in Lil Ray Ray now? He in the room with the cops. This their job. This what they do. They just turned the little thug nigga. So, little Ray Ray, little pussy ass in there. He ain't even grown man. So I'm just saying, like, little Ray Ray won't go home just like you. So what, you gonna do 40 years or Ray Ray do 7? 5 with good behavior. You do 40 flat.
But do you think that's fair that they can do that, man? Because you gotta think, man. Sammy the Bull, he admitted to 19 murders. And he got 5 years. I mean, how do you make a deal? How does the government make deals with these people? You know, they admit to these murders.
I'm gonna tell you this about the American government. An early admission of guilt goes a long way. in Erlangen, Michigan, because everything costs money with these motherfuckers.
And to let the fans know, we're talking the government. We're talking, you know, the feds, not the state, you know, the county, the regular police. It all costs money, but the government. We're talking about the government, y'all. Keep going.
That shit costs them money.
Right.
Keep playing around with your ass. But with the feds, with the government, when they bring your ass in, they got you. They got all the evidence. They followed you, your friends, shit's time to play. State, it's a little different, but what Ray Ray gonna tell? What Ray Ray gonna tell? So if you do it and beat motherfuckers to the punch, so what? You played the game wrong? I ain't condoning nothing. I'm just asking questions. You wanted to get home to your family too, but you wanted to be a G? Let me tell you something. While you being a G, niggas out here raising their babies, their life change. Niggas used to run with working in Wendy's and shit, nigga. They can't send you no dough. They got four kids while you locked up. Nigga had four babies while you locked up, nigga. Got put on child support. Niggas getting smoked. You know what I'm saying? Niggas out getting smoked, nigga. They living the life you was living. So what now? Yo ass in the jail being a G. For some niggas who ain't even here no more. Or on their way to where you at for some other shit. I'm just saying, I ain't telling you what to do other than to get the fuck out the game. Get out the game. When you look at the major players from back in the day and they tell you how and why, it was a war. It was funding a war, right? That's what that's everybody's claim to fame. Ain't no fucking war right now. So who y'all hustling for? And what y'all hustling for? They was getting money. I know it's money in the pill game and this lean game. It's a setup. It was a setup then. So what y'all think it is now? Get out the game. You in the game? 10 to 20 bands? Bids start you a business. Got out the game. Got out the way. Telling you.
And that's just 10 to 20 bands. You're not even talking about the millionaires that people already had millions.
Like money, because this how I'm gonna look at it. What you doing for 30 bands that'll cost you what? Let's just say 9 years. 9 years. They got out here making $12 an hour and make 30 bands in a year. In a year. So while you gone for 30 bands, he gonna make 8 times that.
And there's people that have got life for less than that.
He's doing 20 years for
$500.
$18,000 lick, a $5,000 lick. And when you think about that, the time,
It ain't worth it.
And you could have made $5,000 a legal way so many times in 8 years, in 20 years. I mean, but sometimes you gotta get it how you live out here. Like, you know, mental illness too. That's a whole nother subject. A whole nother topic.
Yeah, that's a whole nother topic and shit,
And that's a lot. That got a lot to do with it, you know?
It do.
To deal with it, you know. It's a problem in our community.
Right, man. All right, that was a good answer, man. We can end that segment on that note, man. That's a real good positive. You know what I mean? So basically, to all y'all out there, you know what I mean? To anybody that's watching this video, if you feel like, you know what I mean, if you do what you're doing, you get busy, man, get out the game. No.
Yeah, get in and get out, man. If you gotta
Invest.
That's what you gotta do.
Get up out of there.
If you in poverty, you down and out, and that's what you gotta do is jump in and like. But I'm just saying, it ain't what it used to be. So right now it's to the point where I don't even really understand why somebody would even be trying to participate in that. I mean, but then, you know, they said Alpo had some drugs. Like, for him to even have drugs is crazy. Like, who would buy or sell anything to this guy? Like, this dude is the world's biggest informant. Like, and it, like, he's like bigger than, he's bigger than 6ix9ine. Like, he's bigger than 69.
Well, that kind of go to what we was talking about earlier. You know, where, you know, people kind of say he was a little cocky, because in all reality, when you think about it, when you do all of that time and you've actually killed 14 people, man, like, you got victims that's still out here, you know, and for you to just come home and, you know, it's kind of like you still acknowledging it, doing the documentaries, and it's like he didn't change in a way.
I said it when I seen the documentary. I said
he didn't change when he came home, it seemed like.
After that long, for him to come home like that, like, I can honestly say, like, if he would have came home and he was, like, trying to mentor or get back to the community in some type of way, I don't think it would be like that, because I think that people just looking at just would just be like, that's Alpo? Like, this nigga's in a suit, or, you know, he got a whatever the Jews wear, the yarmulkes, or, you know what I mean?
Like, mm-hmm.
He coming out the mosque, you know what I'm saying? Or he preaching. His goal is to not see somebody do the same or go down the same path as him.
He should have been on some positive stuff.
So because
how long, like, did he do again? How long was he locked up for?
24, 26, something like that. 26 years. Like, that's some people, like, this generation ain't even been here that long. That's out here right now, wilding out to the drill music, all that. You know what I'm saying? Which I fucks with heavy, you know? I fuck with the youth, you know what I'm saying?
It's a lot of
time. How am I saying I don't fuck with their music when I dealt with a generation in front of me that said the same thing about our music? You know, that's why I don't understand old folks. Like, you know, I don't understand, like, when they say that's good music, you know what I'm saying? All old music ain't good music. Mrs. Jones. Like, this shit about cheating. What the fuck, nigga? That shit sound good to the motherfucker. That shit feel good when you listening to it. You know what I'm saying? Mrs. Jones, nigga. That nigga's talking about fucking Mr. Jones' wife, nigga. That shit sound good to the motherfucker, though.
Yeah.
Doing some real shit, like.
That's a good point, though, man.
Yeah.
25 years.
I mean, my music or y'all music is fucked up. Like, what the fuck you talking about, nigga? I go back and listen to that shit. I can point out some shit in your shit, too.
That's a long time, man. That's 25 years. Like you said, the youth. Some people that's in that drill scene, they ain't even made it to this. You know what I mean? Like,
that nigga was in jail before niggas in niggas' nutsacks.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And he was out here putting in that work and seeing money. You know what I'm saying? Getting pussy and doing dirt and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? So, for him to come back, you know what I'm saying, 20 something, over a quarter century later, and you come back and you don't got no, I ain't gonna say he ain't have, like, of course he didn't age, probably has some more game about him, you know what I'm saying, but at the same time, like, it wasn't a humble sighting when you see. It was still look at me, Alpo. You know what I'm saying? So you can learn a lot from, like, if you ain't learned nothing from that, like, this was, like, world-breaking news. Like, this what y'all want to be. You know what I'm saying? You want to be the biggest gangster in the world? And this the biggest gangster in the world. Like, we ain't seen no shit like this ever. We ain't seen no shit like this. Nigga, ever. Barnes ain't get fucking blew away in Harlem. That nigga somewhere ducked the fuck off fat.
So let me ask you a question. Have you ever in your life, you know, I'm pretty sure you've seen a lot in the streets, but have you ever seen something personally or know somebody that have testified or, you know, maybe have told and, you know, put people away for 40, 50 years and something drastic has happened to them or their family? You got any stories about that? Any quick stories that you can give us? Something you heard? Anything?
Of course, we live in Columbus, like, it's a little, what they call us, the smallest city, the biggest town in the United States. Yeah, big time players here, you know, they get told on, you know. Your crew too big, somebody gonna tell. That's all I'm gonna tell you. You know, you gotta, just like in anything, sports, basketball, prime example, five players on the court, your weakest link, that's your biggest downfall, your weakest link. How strong is your weakest link? So when you out here with your crew, how strong is your weakest link? You ain't testing these dudes? Supposed to be testing these dudes. See where loyalty at. No? What do you got to lose? I mean, you know, put up 10 bars on all of them and take one down every time you see he got something to lose. Nigga just had a baby. Nigga just got married. Oh. Nigga right here, he ain't got no baby. Mama gone. Everything. You know what I'm saying? You don't know his daddy. He out here thugging. He ain't got nothing to lose. The other niggas, they love other shit. You're there to get the money. That's why you gotta be there. You can't be there for nothing else. You can't be there to shine. You can't be there to be flashy. In and out, like anything else. In and out of pussy. In and out the car, nigga. In and out the club, nigga. In and out the game, bro. I'm telling you.
There it is.